Hi, I'm Atul, and I am based in London right now.
Hi, I'm Paul, and I'm an A-level chemistry tutor based in Burnley, Lancashire right now. So today we're going to look at calculating an enthalpy change using enthalpy of formation and enthalpy of combustion data. So previously we've looked at just using enthalpy of formation data or just using enthalpy of combustion data. So this is a little bit trickier. So calculate the enthalpy of combustion of propanone given the information of the enthalpy of combustion of hydrogen and carbon and the enthalpy of formation of propanone. So a couple of ways we can have a go at this. So as we're asked for the enthalpy of combustion of propanone, we can have a go at the equation for that. So propanone plus oxygen will give us carbon dioxide and water. And then to balance that, we've got three carbons on the left, so we'll need three carbon dioxides on the right. Six hydrogens on the left, so we'll need three H2Os on the right. And then we've got nine oxygens on the right. And so if we put four oxygens there, we'll have nine oxygens on the right. So now we've got the balanced equation, we can do our enthalpy cycle. And we're given the enthalpy of formation of propanone, so we can do our arrow going towards propanone from the elements being carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. So we'd need three carbons and three hydrogens. And four and a half oxygens. And on the arrow, we can put the enthalpy changes just for one mole, so that would be -217. And then we've got the enthalpies of combustion of hydrogen and carbon, so we go away from what we're combusting. So carbon to carbon dioxide, hydrogen to water, and enthalpy of combustion is carbon is -393, and that's times by 3 because there's 3 moles of carbon in CO2, and then hydrogen -286, and again that's times by 3. And this is the enthalpy change of combustion that we're trying to calculate. So, seeing as we're going from left to right, then we're going against the propanone arrow and with the carbon dioxide arrows. So if we're going that way, and if we're going against the arrow, it's the opposite reaction, so we change the sign. So our enthalpy of combustion here will equal +217. And then the other ones just stay the same, so add 3 -393 and add 3 -286. And push that into the calculator. So 217 plus 3 times -393 plus 3 times -286 is -1820. Kilojoules per mole. Okay, so we'll have a look at another way of doing this. So this time, because we're given the enthalpy of formation of propanone, we can write the equation for the enthalpy of formation of propanone. So we form propanone from its elements in their standard states under standard conditions. And the elements here would be three carbons and three H2s. And we'd also need half an oxygen. And then we can use the enthalpies of combustion of hydrogen and carbon. So we're going away from carbon, away from hydrogen. And we're given the enthalpy of formation of propanone, which is -217. And we want to calculate the enthalpy of combustion of propanone, which is this arrow. So this time our enthalpy of combustion would go here. And then our 3 times -393 for carbon goes here. And our 3 times -286 for hydrogen goes here. And we could write our combustion products as 3 CO2s and 3 H2Os. And then if we look going from the bottom to the top of this arrow, we'd be going that way. So we'd be going against the -217 and with the 3 times -293 and 3 times -286. So our enthalpy of combustion would equal +217. And then 3 -393 add 3 -286, and that would give us exactly the same answer as -1820 kilojoules per mole. And that's it. Two ways of calculating enthalpy change when given both enthalpy of combustion and enthalpy of formation data. One where you write the equation for the question you've been given, and the other where you write the equation for one of the enthalpies you've been given.
Right. And it works out because basically you just, as long as you follow the right direction of the arrow clockwise or anti-clockwise, keep it consistent.
Yeah, as long as you keep with Hess's law, that the enthalpy change is independent of the route taken.
Okay. And it also, just like thinking in maths, it feels like a vector type thing anyway. So if you're going in one direction, you can take the long route as well to get to that direction, provided you follow the right direction and take into account the direction of the arrow.
Exactly, yes.
Brilliant. Yeah, so nice, neat way of doing that. I look forward to the next in the series of Hess's law and energy calculations.
Okay, thank you.
All right, nice one. Bye for now.
Thanks, Cecil. Bye.